So much. Christmas is a time for family food and those holiday traditions as well. For the next few days here on the Tri-CW and the Local Vibe, we're inviting you into our families and talking about our favorite traditions with some very special guests you might realize or recognize. That's the word.
Recognize.
Talitha Vickers, the one and only. Talitha, thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
So you got a lot on the table.
Okay. So I know you love to entertain.
Let's go.
I know that you love a good presentation.
Yes.
So I had to bring it for you, Devontae.
You brought
today.
It too.
Okay?
It looks good.
So I have, my family is West Indian. And what we do is a traditional drink. It's called sorrel. And sorrel is a drink that is only, you usually have it in the Jamaican culture around Christmas time.
Right.
And it has this beautiful wine hue, and it's made from the sorrel plant. So I'm going to take you through some of the ingredients, and I'll take you in the kitchen. So
can you just eat this by itself?
Okay, no.
Nope.
We're not going to eat
One
this.
One step ahead.
So it kind of looks like potpourri. It's dry, you know, and it's kind of like crunchy, but when you add it to water, it kind of dilutes into this like beautiful wine color. So it's from the hibiscus plant. It's like the cousin of the hibiscus.
Okay.
And then so you're going to need some sugar, and we don't really measure, you know, so it's like just grab
just
some sugar,
a little bit of
sugar, an orange. I didn't have an orange, but this is a tangerine. You're going to use this as a peel. Some cinnamon sticks. Yep. And ginger. Okay. And these are the ingredients that you're going to have. But I want to take you inside the kitchen to show you how to put it all together.
Let's look.
We're going to take our sorrel and add this to a pot of boiling water. Then we will peel our orange and we'll add the peel of the orange to the pot. Next we'll add our cinnamon sticks and we'll peel our ginger, slice it and place it in the pot, and we'll let that steep for about an hour to an hour and a half. After that we're going to be straining our sorrel drink over the sink with a cheesecloth. Once that's done, we will go ahead and add our port wine, the overproof rum, and about a cup and a half of sugar, and mix that all together. Let that sit cool, and then you can add ice or you can just drink it as plain at room temperature.
Deidre, do we have this all the time? When do you typically have sorrel?
Well, we typically have sorrel around the Christmas time. This is a Jamaican or West Indian tradition, and this is something that's staple in our culture.
Okay, great.
All right, let's get cracking.
First off, your mom looks great.
Oh,
she looks great.
Thank you.
Is this something you drink warm or cold? Wait till it chills off?
So you can have it warm, but we typically add ice to it.
Okay.
I didn't add any rum to this here in case you wanted to taste it, but you can always add the rum. It's kind of like eggnog or rum punch. You can always add something.
Like a mocktail almost.
Yes, and it's perfect. So you can serve, I like it served cold, but then on top of all of that, West Indians were very, very smart. So you know that there are health properties. We're not just going to cook up anything just for cook up, all right?
Yeah, the health benefits.
One is weight loss. Two, there's like enzymes to like kind of break down and help you digest food. Vitamin A, high in vitamin A, high in vitamin C, so vision, as well as to boost your immune system. It's an antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, and it also has some properties to help prevent the development of cancer cells, prevent heart disease, low blood pressure, reduce monthly cramps. I mean, there's so much.
Everything is checked
into.
Off.
And then, you know, we're always getting together around the holidays, you know, so this is good to help prevent cold and flu too as well, because of all of the vitamins that are packed into this one little potpourri looking type-esque substance. But it's a plant, and it's something that we love to have and love to celebrate.
It has a nice smell to it too.
Yes, and it's a very, I'm glad you brought that up. So it has a very gingery taste, and you add more sugar if you want it sweeter, you add more more cinnamon if you want more spice
so
to it.
So either way,
And that's why we don't measure, because it's really to your own taste.
There you go. Talitha, thank you so much. I can't wait to try some while Christina gives us the news headlines of the day. Christina, take it away.